So welcome everyone, and today I'm super excited to welcome Bianca Lewis, more commonly known as BSI Lab on the internet. She is a 13-year-old hacker and maker. She was the younger speakers at HOPE and has spoken at DEF CON in the Voting Village, Biohacking Village, and the Roots Asylum Kids Con. She has received national attention when she hacked the voting reporting system at DEF CON 26, and this work has been highlighted at the U.S. Congressional hearing on election security. Very timely topic. BSI Lab is also the founder and CEO of Girls Who Hack, an organization focused on teaching girls the skills of hacking so that they can change the future. She enjoys inventing things, giving talks, and teaching classes on making, programming, and hacking. Welcome, BSI Lab.
Hi, I'm so glad to be here.
Yeah, so great to have you. I love your background, and we were just chatting about that before we hit the record button. But before we dive into the nitty-gritty of your background, the Zoom background, tell us a bit about how you grew up. Have you always been a hacker? At what point did you start thinking about being a hacker and coder?
Well, my dad has worked in AV and programming, so when I was in kindergarten, first grade, around that time, he started me with this beginner block-based program called Scratch, and I started playing around with that for a while.
So you were inspired by your father, and how was it like when you first tinker with Scratch? What did you make? Do you remember some of your first projects?
Oh, I remember I had this one project. It was my mom's birthday, and I didn't want to just make her a physical card. I wanted to make her an interactive game card using Scratch. So I had all the little Scratch characters come up and have it be a little birthday party. It was really fun to make.
Amazing. That's such a special gift to your mom, and you know, something that not a lot of moms would say, like their daughter coded a Christmas card, a birthday card that is interactive for them. So you're commonly known as BSI Lab, and can you share about how this name come about? You know, how long have you had this name for?
Well, BSI Lab stands for Bianca Science Laboratory. I don't know how long I've had it. I think I kind of just got it because every single hacker has a hacker name or a little handle that has a backstory to it. Mine, I kind of just came up with because I love science. I also have, like it shows somewhere around here, Be a Hack Lab, which is my for my hacking. I have Be a Bio Lab, which is when I do biology things. I have Be a Bot Lab when I work with robots. Just a bunch of different names for me for different fields.
Amazing. So you have a lot of different hats that you wear whenever, depending on what type of interest you're exploring. So kind of want to go back to like the Scratch. After you started learning Scratch, how did you go on this journey of becoming a hacker that you are today?
After I played around with some Scratch, I had a bunch of different science fair projects, and I didn't want to make a baking soda volcano or the floating egg like everyone else. So I started exploring some biology. So I grew this plant called Oxalis stricta, and I varied the amount of the MS media, which is a group of chemicals, to it. Long story behind that. And I wanted a cool time-lapse video of these plants I was making for my science fair project. So I took a Raspberry Pi that I had lying around, and I programmed it to be able to take a time-lapse video of these plants growing. And that sparked my interest in more working with Raspberry Pis, Arduinos, and more programming.
Wow. So you're a builder, you're an inventor, and you were also one of the first people who hacked the mock election reporting system that we talked about in the introduction. So how easy was it for you to and the kids to hack it?
Okay, so at the Roots Asylum, which is in DEF CON, it's like the little mini kids con inside of DEF CON, they held this mock election reporting system exactly like the one in Florida, like an exact replica, not made purposefully easy to hack. It was an exact replica. And us kids got to use SQL injection to change the vote count. I had never really thought about election security before that. It was super easy for all of us. Every kid got a packet. Keep in mind, they probably have no background experience in hacking. They read through the packet in like 3 minutes. Then they were able to change the vote count in 10 to 11 minutes. It was very scary because it was so easy.
Wow. So, and then you started the Secure Open Vote, which is your own end-to-end election system built on open source standards. How did you get inspired to create this Secure Open Vote?
I got started with Secure Open Vote, during when we got to hack the mock election reporting system. I got interviewed by a few different news sites, and Congresswoman Mickey Sherrill of New Jersey invited me to go to a congressional hearing on election security. So I got to go out to Washington, D.C., watch that, learn to see what every congressman and woman had to say about election security and what they knew about it and whatnot. It was an eye-opening experience. And I'm like, it's really, really easy to make a secure election system. Even I could do this. And I'm like, why don't I do this? So I started Secure Open Vote.
Amazing. And so this kind of, is that something that inspired you to start Girls Who Hack? How did it come about for you to found this organization that encouraged more girls to develop the skill of hacking?
I think before or after, these two things happened simultaneously, basically. I went to this conference, I'm not sure where, and I learned about this company, Girls Who Code, that teaches girls how to code. And I'm like, well, I'm kind of interested in hacking. I've done hacking before at different conferences and I've tested it out. I want to teach other girls how to hack. So I started Girls Who Hack. I provide online and physical classes to any girl who wants to start her journey in cybersecurity. I've done them at different B-sides and whatnot. But recently I've had to switch to more online methods of telling people about Girls Who Hack and sharing different videos and things on how to hack online because of certain recent situations.
Yeah, totally. A lot of different organizations are moving the workshops and community online. And for our audience who may not know too much about hacking, sometimes when we think about hacking or hackers, like it always seems like people who are, you know, in a dark room that are typing in some screen, like a dark screen with green words, and trying to like steal from a bank or doing something really secretive. So tell us more about what hacking means. Like, how would you describe that to someone who don't know what it is?
Yeah, hacking is pretty bad. Hacking is manipulating software or hardware to get something in turn, like social security numbers, passwords, to be able to change things and make things happen for bad and for good. What people don't know is there are technically three types of hacker. There's black hat hackers and white hat hackers. Black hat hackers, they're the bad guys. They're the guys you think of that are like hacking into banks and whatnot. White hat hackers, they're the good guys. They hack into different machines legally because owner of some company is like, hey, we have this new machine. Can you please come and hack it and tell us how you were able to hack it so that we can then secure it better? So hacking can be used as a good thing or a bad thing.
That's amazing. Like, that is a great explanation. And so not all types of hacking is bad. And the white hat hacking is actually something that's defensive to or protecting a company or protecting a system from having vulnerabilities or security flaws in the system so that you can build like a more secure software for the users. So can you share a bit about like for Girls Who Hack, how do you engage members in your organization to encourage more people to develop the skill of hacking?
So with Girls Who Hack, as I said, I have different online lessons and whatnot. In these online lessons, I go over the basics of the basics. Usually hacking courses online say, okay, we're going to do this now, but you have no background knowledge. There's almost nothing with background knowledge. With Girls Who Hack, most of my classes, well, all of my classes are for beginners. Beginners who've never done anything. what's really surprising to me, honestly, when I began Girls Who Hack, I was like, are girls actually going to want to learn to hack, or is it just me? Are they going to enjoy it? Are they going to want to listen to me? Or are they just going to sit there and do whatever and then just go home? But when I did these classes, I was honestly kind of surprised because the girls there were eager to learn, and they're girls my age, a little older and a little younger. It was kind of amazing to see them be like, hey, so what if I do this? And I'm like, you can also do that too.
Amazing. Yeah. And I feel like this is a subject where, you know, it sounds intimidating, but it's also like figuring out a piece of like a puzzle, right? Where, oh, looking at like what fits and like what is the vulnerability of a system. And so let's say someone is brand new to hacking, right? So what would be one of the most beginner friendly project that you someone can learn how to hack from?
I actually have a class online that I've done where I teach anyone who wants to learn how to make their own home lab so that they can begin hacking in a safe environment instead of hacking on their own laptop and then maybe messing up their whole entire laptop in their system. So I have a class on making a virtual machine on your normal laptop or on another laptop so that you can begin hacking. And that's probably the number one class I recommend for people to try out if they want to begin learning how to hack.
That sounds like a lot of fun. I wish I can also join that as well. So looking forward for Girls Who Hack, you've been building it, the community, for a while now. What is your vision for Girls Who Hack?
Well, I feel like I really want Girls Who Hack. I want to make a bunch of online lessons. I'd really like to get the word of Girls Who Hack out to maybe different schools to be able to teach classes at schools for all the girls at schools in their computer class or their gaming club on how to start in cybersecurity. That's probably one of my biggest goals.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of girls are super into gaming now, and having one more layer of education on that as they learn about video games or making their own games and also learning about computer security will be very valuable. And so I want to switch gears and talk a bit about online communities. So aside from Girls Who Hack, you're also active on the Steam Squad. So tell us more about the Steam Squad.
So the Steam Squad is this awesome group of girls who are leading entrepreneurs in Steam. They range in different topics from making robots to space and airplanes and engineering and all these crazy girls. But you need to think, they're humans too. They're people too. And they're actually really fun to talk to. It's this amazing community where us girls have this one group chat on Twitter where we can talk to each other and just share our feelings, our thoughts. We can tell each other good news, bad news, ask for advice. It's like a giant club of friends or even sisters.
Wow, that's amazing. And so from my understanding, Steam Squad, all the girls in Steam Squad are located all around the world, all over the country. So how is it like having this like virtual group of friends?
It's kind of crazy actually, because they're, like you said, from everywhere, from all different backgrounds. They have different stories, and it's just amazing to learn about different people and their parts of the world and the way they view different topics, because they view things differently from where we do, you know?
Yeah, I think that for this generation that you're in, like, the world is really about, like, the community is on the internet. So having a Twitter group chat, or some young people like to hang out on Discord, and it's just becoming this like powerful network that you can find really like-minded people anywhere in the world and connect with them and chat with them. So BSI Lab, you have a lot on your plate. You are running Girls Who Hack, active on Steam Squad, creating lessons for Girls Who Hack. And so what are you building next? What are you curious about?
Well, currently I've been working on my election system, Secure Open Vote. To make an election system, you need to make it end-to-end. You can't just make it one part. So everything from the registration system to the election machines to the reporting system to the tabulator. So far, I've made the reporting system, and now I'm working on the registration system. And I would like to have basically a scratch sketch version of the whole entire system for DEF CON this year. Last year for DEF CON, this year for DEF CON, actually, because it's still 2020, mm-hmm. I had the reporting system, and I had it out for hackers to try to hack, because ESNS and Dominion, who make the largest producers for election systems in the U.S., they hide their source code, and they're like, nope, you can't look at our stuff, you can't try to hack it, and I'm like, no, try to hack it, tell me how I can secure it. What are the problems with it? So I want to have my whole entire election system, well, just a base version of it. I can't finish an entire election system in a year, for DEF CON next year, so that I can have people test it, tell me how I can fix it, how I can make it better, and just learn and grow from there.
Amazing. And I love that you're challenging yourself by putting your code out there and basically having people poke holes at your programming and to see if there's any flaws. And I think that's a really great attitude to have. And so what is your dream career? And it seems like your interests are so broad and there's so many things you're great at. So what is your dream career?
I don't really have a dream career because I'm living it. I'm living my dream career right now. I've already started my companies and I just want to go from here, grow with them, see if I can make these companies a big deal, a bigger thing, and help make the world a better place.
Love it. Love it. Like what you're building, you're already working on things that you care about. You have a great group of girlfriends that are also really awesome entrepreneurs. So I can just see the sky is the limit for you. So what about like women in STEM? Like aside from the STEAM squad, who are your favorite women in STEM?
Number one is definitely Lady Ada. She's one of the first people I heard about in this community. She started her company Adafruit. She makes a bunch of different boards and different kits to do all sorts of things like different LED projects and whatnot. And she's just super awesome. She had a dream like I did, and she's like, you know what? I think I'm gonna do this. And she did it.
Yeah, like there's something to say about having a whole company and a product that's named after herself, right? Like it's just like, wow, like everyone knows like Adafruit. And so do you have any tips for young girls who are not yet in the STEAM squad level and they're wanting to start becoming a hacker?
Well, I definitely say check out Girls Who Hack, but also if you don't want to just do Girls Who Hack, there are different online resources for you. Nowadays, there's hundreds and hundreds of different free online classes in different things from coding to hacking and everything, game developing even, if you want to make your own games. So just go on the internet. And also, if you really want to get started more into hacking, I'd also suggest going to hacker conferences like B-Sides is all around the US. Depending on where you are, there's definitely going to be one close by you. And go to one of those conferences, try out a CTF or two, try out, make new friends, talk to people and see what you're interested in. Try a little bit of everything until you're like, I want to deep dive focus into this and become an expert.
Wait, so I want to jump in a little bit here. CTF, like what does that stand for a layman like myself?
CTF stands for Capture the Flag is a cool hacker game, basically, where you're given a bunch of hacking puzzles in different things, like there's some where you need to know some hacker terminology. There's some where you need to know how to use Wireshark to be able to capture packets. And by doing so and completing these hacking challenges, you get a little thing called a flag you plug in the flag and you get points for it. And you see if you can get points on the leaderboard. You can ask people nearby you to help you. You can create a team together so that your team can compete in a CTF, and they're really fun to do.
Awesome. So definitely recommend the audience to check out working on a CTF challenge. So BSLF, where can we find you on the internet? Since you're active there and you have a community there, how can we connect with you?
I have a bunch of forums on bsilab.com. You can also check out girlswhohack.com, secureopenvote.com. You can go follow me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and yeah, that's basically it.
Amazing. Yeah, I can't wait to follow on what you're going to create next. And I'm super excited to learn a little bit about computer security after talking to you as well. So thank you so much, BSLF, for joining this conversation. It's so great to have you.
Thank you so much for having me. This was an awesome experience.